have been working on implementing the GTTM theory on the computers, and to some extent we have succeeded about implementation of the GTTM theory. And sound may hear, however, we cannot. Where is sound? I have a sound here. Let me try. No sound. Where is sound? Here. Sound. Anyway, let me start my talk from the beginning. So that I am a person from a school of semiotics. And first of all, I have two basic questions. One is, what does does music written on the score mean? The second is, what does the sounding note in music mean? So I'd like to share these questions with you. And for what do I put such questions? One reason is that I would like to be oriented to build a computational musicology, and in which, according to my image, the computational music musicology is something that where we can manipulate sound or music like numbers. And the second point, the cognitive reality, which means that computation for computational musicology is parallel with cognition. That is my claim for my research. And maybe that is tightly coupled with the concept of symbol grounded. Okay. And this slide shows you the simple framework of semiotics. If you see the icon of apple or word apple on the surface level, your brain easily associates with the icon, with the real thing, a apple or fruit. And in semiotics, the surface layer is a representation or symbol. And the entity level, we call them a referent level. Okay, and the icon of apple and the word apple is easily associated with the real world entity. However, what do you think of melody or chord like this? What entity should be associated with those? So this is the question I'd like to share with you. And association occurs. That is the moment we get a meaning of the icon or surface level representation. And we are going to the two big major schools of music theory. One is the Schenkerian analysis, and the other is GTTM, the generative theory of tonal music. And many of you know well more than I, maybe. And Schenker rewrite the surface level score, only the surface level, but he didn't think of different level. See? And he finally gets to the ersatz structure. And in contrast, the GTTM, the Leodahl and Jackendorf, may rewrite the surface level structure, but in fact, or essentially, they are discussing about the referent level structure, to be associated with the surface structure. So that I will show you some indirect evidence of the structure. Because this is an excerpt from the GTTM book, and as you probably know well, and the left-hand side at the top is the surface. And they, Leda and Jackendorf, rewrote the surface structure into the most simple scores.
by reduce or remove or eliminate the each node step by step. And they look at the intermediate scores. This is not a real score. There's no stem and the flags, just a node head, which is not a real node, sounding node. It implies us that this image is a kind of indirect evidence. They, Leonard and Jackendorf, thought of the meaning of music in the framework semiotics, with a surface level and a different level. See? And this, and also the, I think that different level, they introduced the tree structure as a kind of representation meaning. This is a very important thing they made. And yes, they, actually I agree with them upon tree structure introduced. Many, many things I wrote. And the second paragraph, you can see a tree is innate in music. That's maybe a significant point in terms of the semantics of music from a GT10 point of view. And say, a tree represents a kind of musical meaning, which is basically relatively common and stable. So the tree structure, like actually the time spans tree and the prolongation tree, is a good starting point to for discussing the music, music meaning, I think. So that this is that was it's been the first part of my claim from a semiotics perspective point of view. This is the start of the second part. That there are many differences within music. If you listen to this melody, they consist of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 notes, and when you are here in the center E note, see, E, Mi or something like that. When you listen to the E sound, E note, then in your brain, there should be a references to the previously heard notes and the future notes to be heard at the same time. In language we use, there is a demonstrative pronoun like it or this and he and she, and this word may refer to something else or a real world thing. And if a context is given, you can easily estimate or anticipate the meaning of it or this. However, there is no such a convenient convenient word in music. So if you listen to a individual note, your brain may differ to another, the other all event at the same time, and your brain may estimate or evaluate the relationship or strengths of the differences at the same time. And if you listen to a E note, so that maybe the differences to C note or G note is stronger than the D note and F note or A note. And the long differences may be weaker than the shorter differences. But something like that happens in your brain at the same time when you listen to a single E note. So these differences make a meaning, see, meanings. And that those meanings may be split into two types. One is the differences make a gestalt, which means a group. The other hand, the reference means an implication or prediction or anticipation. See?
So two kinds of cognitive effect we get. And this is, so I showed you some images of gestalt and implication. And the gestalt makes up groups. Groups makes a hierarchy. In contrast, the implication and prediction makes, as you probably know, the implication realization model proposed by Namur. So these two kinds of cognition may happen at the same time in our brain, our mind.
Music, then you can easily see such cognitions of grouping and association of two or more than notes. But I don't have not so much time, so I'd like to skip of this simple example. As you probably know, the ta-ra-ta-ta-ta-ra-ta-ta song, and have a half cadence and authentic cadence in between. There is a kind of expectation we have, and the first half of the first half part of the song has ta-ra-ta-ta-ta-ra-ta-ta, and also the fifth and the sixth bar and the ta-ra-ta-ta-ra-ta. This is very same as to each other, and the repetition is a very good clue to detect the group, and also the group is here and the group is here in your brain, so that there is a mutual references you get. So the two schools are inevitable, and we studied the recognition novel reference from a semiotics point of view. Then we can get the gestalt or group cognition. It follows the hierarchy. Then the GTTM theory treats such an intuition or cognition. On the other hand, that similarly started with the reference, but Namur's intuition treat the implication prediction perspective of references. Then he set or defined many kinds of association between the individual notes on the score. Then he proposed the IR model. Okay, so that these two schools are very complementary views into the single phenomena of music. Okay. Maybe this is the last slide. Okay. This is the end of my talk.